Cushman & Wakefield, one of the country's biggest commercial real estate companies, is doing just that, planning to rotate just 25% of employees into the office at a time once each state gives them the green light.
So how are they going to sit?
So in this six-pack here, there'd be an employee sitting here, there'd be an employee sitting in the middle on that side, and then there'd be an employee sitting diagonally across from that person.
Their plan is called the 6 feet office. Along with more sanitizing and deeper cleaning, workers will walk the office clockwise and only clockwise to minimize traffic jams and congregating. They're adding colored arrows to indicate traffic flow and offering disposable placemats to cover desks.
What's going to happen with the traditional conference room?
Well, the conference room, I think, seats about 30 people, so it's a sizable boardroom. The plans that we have established for return to work is that we'd have no more than 6 people in that boardroom at any time.
Six.
And you would enter in one
direction.
That's 20%. It's 20%. And we would enter one direction and exit another, clockwise, every time.
Every part of the office is going to look different, especially common areas like this. No more sitting directly next to your colleague. You have to be 6 feet apart in every direction.
But all this distance certainly takes away from the intangible benefits of being at the office.
If you are a young associate at Cushman & Wakefield, are you missing some of the mentorship? And the answer is yes.
Yeah.
I do think we'll get back there. I think what we're talking about is hopefully a short-term or medium-term issue.
Till that happens, we might be getting more done from home.
There are some downsides in terms of loneliness and not being with your colleagues and not feeling connected to your team. But on balance, it's less stressful. People who say they, when they're at the office, they're losing 75 minutes a day to interruptions. And at home, they're losing 35.